Hello and welcome to another video of Rethink Biology. Today's topic is life cycle of dengue virus. In this video, we will see how the dengue virus infects human cells and replicates itself. The dengue virus is a spherical virus that has a protein coat called the envelope and a core of genetic material called the RNA. The envelope has two types of proteins, envelope protein E and precursor M protein PRM. The RNA encodes three structural proteins, C, M and E, and seven non-structural proteins, NS1, NS2A, NS2B, NS3, NS4A, NS4B and NS5. The fully mature dengue virus don't have PRM proteins on their surface. The infection begins when the dengue virus attaches to the surface of a human cell using its E protein to bind to specific receptors. The cell then engulfs the virus in a process called endocytosis, forming a vesicle inside the cell. The vesicle becomes acidic, which triggers a change in the shape of the E protein. This causes the fusion of the viral envelope with the vesicle membrane, releasing the RNA into the cell. The RNA is then translated by the cell's ribosomes, producing a long polyprotein that is cleaved by the viral protease NS2B or NS3 into individual proteins. The viral RNA is copied by the viral polymerase NS5, producing a negative strand RNA that serves as a template for more positive strand RNA. The positive strand RNA can either be translated into more proteins or packaged into new viral particles. The assembly of new viral particles occurs in the endoplasmic reticulum, where the PRM and E proteins form a complex with the RNA. The immature particles then bud into the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum and travel through the Golgi apparatus, where they undergo a maturation process. The maturation process involves the cleavage of the PRM protein by a cellular enzyme called furin, exposing the E protein and making the particles infectious. The mature particles are then released from the cell by exocytosis, ready to infect more cells. The dengue virus can also evade the immune system by forming immune complexes with antibodies. These complexes can bind to the receptors on other cells, such as dendritic cells, and enhance the infection. This phenomenon is called antibody-dependent enhancement, and it can lead to more severe forms of dengue disease. This concludes our video on the life cycle of the dengue virus. Thank you for watching.